We still have our own challenges. What I believe that we need to do as a country going forward is to ensure that we'll be able to maximize the benefits of our diversity, to ensure that the rainbow we have in Nigeria will be beneficial to all of us. And nobody should be left behind. We must, as a government and as a people, continue to entrench the values of justice, fairness, and equity. In that way, I believe that Nigeria will be greater than what we are today. So on behalf of my constituents and the rest of us, I would like to wish Nigeria a happy independence on October 1, 2017, as we turn 57. May God continue to bless Nigeria, and may we continue to live in unity and to live in peace, so that progress will be our portion. So I congratulate all of us and our constituents on this development, the 57th independence anniversary of Nigeria.
The time has come for us at 57 to be able to take a stock of what we have been through and say to Nigerians, this also will pass. And I believe that if we put everything in place to ensure that the people understand what we're doing as people in charge of governments in Nigeria, and they also know that we mean well for them, we're taking care, we're looking at their welfare, we will be able to have a united, undivided Nigeria. We need to congratulate ourselves, because lesser nations would not have come this far. We thank everyone that has made this union possible.
Coincides with that of Nigeria. Mr. President, it hasn't been an easy journey in the last 57 years. And whilst we congratulate ourselves for staying together as a nation, we must remember our heroes that died in the course of keeping this nation together. May their souls rest in perfect peace. Particularly those that died during the Nigerian Civil War between 1967 and 1970. My prayer is that never again should Nigeria see another civil war, because it's very difficult for any nation to survive two civil wars. And then I do know that as leaders, we have a lot of responsibilities to ensure that Nigeria continues to grow in leaps and bounds, and that we celebrate more decades of big days in future together as a nation. And one of those things we must do is to ensure justice, justice to all and justice for all.
It is important, Mr. President, that in this our 57th birthday, our leaders of this country, should have a sober reflection, because our own time is running, but the generation yet unborn and generation behind us, how are they going to see Nigeria? How are they going to view Nigeria? I think it's a very important thing that we must have a sober reflection. We must see ourselves as one. Those values we know for Nigeria is known for, it's no longer there. October 1st of every year is always a celebration period for everybody, even the little kids. But today, those things are no longer there because of hatreds, because of divisive words.
We should use this opportunity to strengthen the unity, the bond, and the solidarity of our nation. We should use this opportunity to reaffirm our commitment to one and indivisible nation. We should use this opportunity to reform and do all the necessary adjustment that is needed, political, social, and economic, to strengthen our unity as a nation. At this very time, our country is faced with challenges, challenges that seriously undermines our unity, that shakes our solidarity as a people, and that will also define our future. But there are no countries in the world that are without challenges. And we should use what is before us as a lesson and a building blocks for a stronger, more prosperous and progressive nation ahead. Thank you.